Hi Taurus, welcome back to Omkara Tarot and to your first in-depth love read. Of course, your love bites have already been put up on Saturday, but this is the one we're going to go in-depth and check how you're feeling, how your person is feeling, and what action we can expect in this connection. And these are general collective readings. Taurus will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So let's begin. My angel spirit guides, please bless this reading for Taurus and send them the messages they need to hear the most right now. Thank you. All right, Taurus, let's start your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you. Thank you for being here. And Taurus, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. All right, newbies. I'm setting down two sets of cards here. One side will be for you, one side will be for your person. And in the center, I'm going to have your dialogue message cards, your mutual cards, etc. If this is your reading, you will know which side you're on, right? Because for me, this is going to be person A, this is going to be person B. Okay, action for person A and action for person B. Bottom of my deck, I have the Eight of Wands in reverse. No communication is going on here, Taurus, between the two of you. Somebody is trying to heal their broken heart after maybe a fight or a conflict. They just want things to heal, but the fight has happened. There's a lot of conflict. The other person is feeling very emotionally overwhelmed as well, feeling drained out of their emotions because of this imbalance that has been created between the two of you. So, of course, I'll clarify all these cards, Taurus, but first let's start with your dialogue message cards. Let's see if you guys could say something to each other, what that would be, and then we'll do the clarifications. So, Taurus and their person spirit, if they could say something to each other now, what would that be? Taurus and their person. Okay. I'm going to take a few more Taurus from another deck. Taurus and their person. And Taurus, if any of you are looking for personal readings, my email is in the description box below. You can reach me there. Taurus and their person. Taurus and their person. One more. Okay. All right. Good to go, Taurus. Let's start your reading. I would be honored to give you children. Somebody wants somebody to return and heal things between the two of you. You check all my boxes. How can that be possible? Are you sorry for hurting me? I need to control this connection. I'm afraid I'll lose myself in you. No one else comes close to all the good things you've done for me. When I said I'll love you forever, I meant it. I wasn't ready for our connection. My past of how I was raised affects how I act now in life. So somebody misbehaved here. That's what I would feel. They were emotionally closed off. They didn't show their emotions or emotionally manipulating their person. I have a King of Cups this side and I have a Queen of Cups on the other, and they're both upside down. Okay, so let's see what's happening here. Let's start with an angel blessing card. Let's see what my angels have for this read. Then we'll do the clarification, Taurus. So, blessing, guidance, advice, or a message for Taurus, please. Child. Somebody wants to start brand new. Both of you do, actually, but the point is one person wants the person to return and have a brand new beginning. The other person wants to be single and maybe start a brand new life. So new beginnings are on the horizon, it seems, but depends on how you guys now manage this. Let's see what's happening currently. Three of Swords in reverse, person A. I'm going to read just person A right now, okay? So Three of Swords in reverse. Why do you feel this way? Three of Swords in reverse. Why do you feel this way? Yeah, they do want that person. They feel that my person is my person. This is my forever person, right? I want to heal things with the person who's always done kind, beautiful things for me, who is loving, generous, kind. And yes, if there's been an argument or a fight, that doesn't mean I don't want them. But person A is feeling quite down and out. They know they've hurt their partner. But they do want to balance things out or heal the connection, especially now since they feel that the person could be leaving them after this fight or walking away. They do want to fix things between the two of you. They know that some unpleasant memories have been created in this connection, but they do want them back. I don't think they want their person to leave. Yes, they are looking into their future now and they feel, what have I done? They don't want this chapter to shut down. World in reverse again. So what happened, person A? What happened from your perspective? What happened in the recent past for you to be feeling this way? Eight of Cups in reverse. Well, they've been trying to get their person back, even though I think this is a soulmate connection gone wrong. Maybe that love got lost somewhere in the, you know, relationship. But they have been forever wanting a return. They feel that this long-term partnership or commitment is breaking down and they want it back now. Hierophant in reverse as well. Hierophant in reverse is clarified by the Hierophant upright. So whatever has broken down between the two of you, Taurus, this person does want to bring it back. They want that commitment to stay the way it was. This person is very, very stressed out, overthinking, worrying, stressed out, tense. They do want to put in the work somehow to bring this back into the way it was. So how do you feel about the connection now presently, person A? King of Cups in reverse. Well, this King of Cups in reverse is also clarified by the King of Cups. A lot of repeating cards on this side. They feel, yes, I know I'm a little cold. I'm a little, in the sense I hide my emotions. And maybe I have emotionally kind of kept my person stuck. But, you know, the truth of it is I do love my person. I do care for them. I may not show it all the time. I may come across as emotionless, but you know, this works for me. This partnership works for me. I want my partner back. All these games that I've been playing of not showing my emotions or being heartless or being the person in control, all this stuff that I've done, I'm feeling it's backfiring on me now because my person is ready to walk away and I'm very depressed about it. I'm very anxious, I'm very angry, I'm upset, and I just want all this to be over. I'm very frustrated right now. I just don't like this back and forth. Are we together? Are we not? I just want this back and forth to end so that all this devil energy which has come between the two of us can be released. So what action person A will take now? I will open later, Taurus. Let's go on to the other side and see really what's going on. So, oh my God, when did this card come out? I have a Queen of Cups in the upright as well. It may have come out with the King of Cups upright. So yes, this is again came out for person A. So they do feel that, you know, I actually want to be the King of Cups upright and I want them to be my Queen of Cups upright. So what if, you know, in the first spread we both came out reverse? I do want this connection back. I do love them. All right, so person B, why do you feel like the Queen of Cups in reverse? Why do you feel like the Queen of Cups in reverse? Well, person B says, I have been stuck in this connection for a long time, but now I see clearly all the lies, all the deception, all that has now come to light. Whatever I was not clear about is now becoming clear with the moon in reverse. I'm healing myself from whatever I've been through. This connection was very imbalanced. Temperance in reverse. Yes, person B is almost like ready to halt this connection completely because they haven't been really happy in this connection and they want to maybe move towards new love. Person B has been yearning for emotional happiness. They want somebody who will bring them a cup of love. And whereas this connection was concerned, well, they were never truly happy. Maybe there was security, stability, but there was no emotions, there was no romance, there was no love. And it always felt a bit imbalanced to person B. So, from your perspective, person B, what happened to destroy this connection this way? The devil. They feel there was too much of toxicity in this connection, too much of gossip around this connection. My person was very immature. They never moved towards me in the correct way. They were always doing this with me. Five of Swords again, clarified by the Five of Swords. So many repeating cards for you. That they were always cheating, lying and sneaking away and always treating this connection like I was just an option to them. But now it's like I can't handle this anymore. It's over. It's over. I can't be part of this jig anymore. Yeah, this has caused too much delay in my own life. I'd rather do things for myself now. I did wait, but it didn't work out. So, you know what? Person B, the way they see this connection and this person is that, I'd rather now kind of be by myself. Again, this card is again a repeating card. Nine of Pentacles. So I think after a lot of delay, I think person B is deciding it's better that I take care of myself, be independent, be strong, take care of my own life, even if that means being single. Because in this connection, well, none of my dreams are coming true. Nine of Cups in reverse. Nine of Cups upright is, wish fulfillment and having all your wishes come true. This is in reverse. So that's the reason person B may be heading off to have this childlike brand new beginning for themselves, or at least thinking about it. Yes, they don't want to be in limbo for the rest of their life. They don't want to be in this limbo and stuck energy. Which direction should I go? Person B is quite sure that they now have the capability of making their own choice in life. One more. How else do you see this connection? Yes, person B is looking for some happiness in their life. They want joy, they want celebration, which they are not getting here. Justice in reverse. So what action you guys are going to take? Let's do that now. Let's take a different deck for this one, Taurus. And of course, this is my time to request you guys, since you're still watching, even if it's just been entertaining and very little has, resonated. If you could just click that thumbs up button for me right now, this really helps the videos to circulate. And of course, it makes me extremely happy to know that I'm actually connecting with you guys. And newbies, if you have subscribed, don't forget to press the notification bell so you get notified when your next reading will be out, which it will be on Saturday, the Love Bite. The Lovers. But of course, some bonus readings here or there, which I don't announce, they just pop up. So don't miss those as well. Person A, the decision they're making right now is the Lovers. Why is that an action? Why is the Lovers an action? Why is the Lovers an action for person A, Spirit? One more. One more action for person A. Oops. Okay, one more. Well. Person A is knows that it's time to make a choice. They know it's time to make a choice. either they can feel this way, left behind in the cold and let their person leave them and feel miserable for the rest of their life, or they can choose to start a brand new chapter. Let's do this again, and this time you wanted a Knight of Cups, right? You wanted somebody to come be emotionally open with you. Here I am, I'm bringing you flowers and I'll woo you once again. And I'm really looking forward to a reconciliation with you. I'm ready to be open with you. Let's start brand new. Let's end that old chapter of me leaving you out and then you leaving me out. Can we just start again with this childlike, fresh energy? So that's what they want to do. They want to have a reconciliation. All this happiness and joy that person B has been seeking, person A says, I'll bring it to you. Okay, so person B, any action towards person A or otherwise? Four of Cups in reverse. Why is that an action? Why is that an action, person B? What is the action that you will take, person B? Why is the Four of Cups in action? One more. One more. And what is that? Oh God, this. Okay, so person B is taking a little time out. I think they've been through a period of sadness and depression. Person B is curled up right now, trying to wonder, think, make the right decision. Do they want to end this connection and move on to a brand new beginning for themselves? Or should they have a rebirth of this connection, but they fear it may lead to the same cycle once again? So I think person B is right now in contemplation mode, healing themselves. But can you imagine the amount of new cards that I have here? Fool, Child, the World card. So not of new beginnings, but so will you take any action, or are you just going to think for a while, person B? I agree, it's a very big decision, but where are you more inclined towards? What's this Fool card for you? Where would you like to? Ace of Wands, Seven of Pentacles, and one more, and the Page of Cups. Okay, so person A says, I'm just taking a little time out right now. I'm going to have this passionate new beginning in my life, irrespective, with or without them. Yes, I can give them a chance to see if they would like to invest, how much they're going to invest. I have my barriers up now. I am stronger than before, but I'm not making a decision right at this moment. I'm going to give them a chance maybe to either apologize or maybe see if there is some new love out there where I can be happier. So don't push me, Omkara Tarot. Yes, I know I'm on the brink of a new beginning with or without them, but this time it's going to be head over heart. Depends on what investment I see being put by them or not. So yes, that's all I have for you, Taurus. Till next time then, love and light. Take care. Namaste.